Well, good morning and welcome to Morning Gospel Fuel with Mr. G. It is Easter Thursday, May 7th, the feast day of St. John of Beverley. And he was Bishop of York in England in the late 1600s, early 700s, in which many miracles of healings are ascribed to him. And today's gospel is from John chapter 13, verses 16 through 20. So let's begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen, amen, I say to you, no slave is greater than his master, nor any messenger greater than the one who sent him. If you understand this, blessed are you if you do it. I am not speaking of all of you. I know those whom I have chosen. But so that the scripture might be fulfilled, the one who ate my food has raised his heel against me. From now on, I am telling you before it happens, so that when it happens, you may believe that I am. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever receives the one I send receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. There we go. A little wordy there towards the end, I feel like. But we need to lay the foundation of what's happening, or we need to, give the scene. This gospel is the very end of, it's right after Jesus was done washing the disciples' feet. Okay, so it's Holy Thursday, right, where so washing of the feet. So, notice how, Jesus, he even uses evil and betrayal, because this scripture verse, it says, the one who ate my food has raised his heel against me. He's talking about Judas, right? Because, Judas is the one that betrayed him, of course, as we all know. But Jesus even uses evil and betrayal as part of God's fulfillment of scripture. So he just turns everything into good, even if it's evil. Like, he turns everything into good. That's what a lot of people, I think, fail to understand, is that evil doesn't happen in the world because of God. Evil is because of Satan, but God uses evil to turn into good, like he's doing even whenever Judas betrays him. So that's something that you can always use whenever you're defending the faith. Whenever people always say, why does God let bad things happen? He doesn't. All right, Satan's doing that. God just turns a lot of good into it, which we all see. All right, so anyway, some more info. I looked up the footnote on the term messenger. So messenger in Greek is apostolos, which is where the English term apostle comes from. All right, so we are all called to be apostles. All right, so the very last verse, in verse 20, says, amen, amen, I say to you, whoever receives the one I send receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. All right, so from my perspective, I feel like this is, Jesus is talking about 12 disciples, and just the importance of team. They're virtually on the same team, right? Now, granted, we have a bad team member in Judas, right? But they're all on the same team, right? Because, they receive Jesus through the disciples, but then the disciples also receive Jesus through him. So they're all, like, working together for the same common goal, to help build the kingdom of God, right? So, and it says that, Jesus says, I know those whom I have chosen. Right? And he chooses all of us. Right? So we got to use Jesus' example. He is a king and leader who came to serve you, cleanse you from sin, and lay down his life for you. And that's the goal, I think. That's the challenge today, is relative. I think this is kind of scatterbrained again. But the goal of what I try to come up with is, we need to develop our own team, whether it's family, friends, coworkers, whatever. I've learned, primarily through Exodus 90, like, how important it is to form a team of people who are truly trying to become the best version of themselves. And we know innately who, if we're doing that through our discussions. And even men in there, ego and pride. You know, we, you know, Jesus had a team of disciples because even he needed others. All right. So I think that's the challenge today, is who is on your team of faith who tries to challenge each other, grow in virtue, and just become, help each other build up the best version of each other and yourself. Because again, Jesus, you know, I know those whom I have chosen, and he has chosen all of us to help build the kingdom, all right, and all this other stuff. So hopefully, hopefully you got something out of that. I don't know. Hey, have a good Thursday. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and Spirit. Amen.